Hi everyone and welcome back to another video, today with a Halloween card. For my card today I will be combining dies from the latest release by Sizzix. This is called Landscape Border and it's perfect for winter scenes. This is called Whoosh and it creates this lovely design with stars, but you can use them separately if you wish so. And this is the Halloween set with a bunch of images which I am going to use today. For all my die cutting today, I will be using my Sizzix machine and this is the Big Shot Foldaway. As you can see, it is very compact when you put everything together, but you can open up these flaps and lock them in place. You can even open up those flaps and you can see that you can keep tools inside. I have already done a video review and an unboxing video on this machine and I am going to link it up here. You will find the link at the top of your screen as well as at the bottom and you can check that out if you want to learn more. So now let's go ahead and start working on the card. I am going to do some die cutting first and from the Halloween set I'm going to use the hat, the little cat and the broom. And because I want to create a little scene on my card, I am also going to use the border landscape and cut it out. And this die doesn't actually cut out at the bottom, which means that you can have it as far up or low on your project. So anyway, I'm going to place it there and run everything through my Big Shot Foldaway machine. And as you can see, I'm cutting out everything from the same cardstock and I will be coloring everything later on. But of course, you can go the other way and die cut everything from colored cardstock. Now there is also another little die, which is the buckle for the hat, which I am going to cut out now using gold cardstock. I will be adding touches of gold all over the card later on, so you will see how everything will come together. Now I am die cutting a circle out of this masking paper and then I placed that on top of a panel that I completely covered up with distress oxide ink. And here is the panel that I'm talking about. It's my background for my little scene. I am removing the mask that I have placed, which is going to be the moon. As I was doing all the inking, I thought I was filming, but I didn't. In any case, all I did was to just apply black suit and faded jeans all over the place with my blending tools. Now I'm going to add some details on the moon. On my glass mat, I have applied a little bit of Wild Honey Distress Oxide ink and now with a brush, I'm just touching areas of the moon without completely covering it up. Now I'm using my black suit to completely cover up my cat. I'm also going to color black the landscape with the houses and the trees. And of course, you can use your markers to color it or of course, you can cut it out of black cardstock. And here you can see how I colored the hat, so I have completely covered it up with seedless preserves and then I added shadows with dusty concord as well as black soot. And I repeated the same process for coloring the broom. The stick part of the broom is colored with vintage photo while the other part is a mix of vintage photo and wild honey. But again, you can use colored cardstock to cut out all these parts, or you can even use your markers to color everything. Now it's time to put everything together, so I'm adding some glue at the back of the buckle, which I'm going to stick on top of my hat. It gives a lovely shiny detail since this is cut out of gold cardstock. Now I'm going to try to explain my thinking process here. So I want to have this landscape at the bottom, but at the back of all those windows, I want to have some shine with my gold cardstock, but I don't want to cut out all those tiny pieces. So this is what I came up with, which I think it's really clever. So I'm going to use the die and cut out the bottom of my panel. And now as you can see, the black border fits perfectly inside. And now I'm going to stick both these pieces on top of this gold cardstock. And you can also cut out stars at this stage if you want to, then you will get that shine from the back. I'm not going to do that for this card. Instead, I'm just going to stick everything down and you will see that at the end, I will end up having lovely and shiny windows. This process really saved me tons of time. Instead of having to cut out all those tiny little golden windows and stick them in place, now I'm using my scissors to cut off the excess, and my bottom part of the card is ready. Now all I have to do is to put the card together and place her on the sky. Now for adding some dimension, I'm using some foam squares at the back, and actually the foam squares are keeping all those parts of the card together with the broom and the hat. As always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. The dies that I'm using today are from the Sizzix UK, which means that they are available internationally, but I don't know if Sizzix USA has these designs as well. I will check it out and link it below for you guys as well. So now I'm going to use this die, but instead of using the design as it is, I just want to have the stars. I like the fact that I get bigger and smaller stars that I can mix and match on my project, and the idea here is not to add stars on my background. You can see I have no stars whatsoever up to now. I'm going to stick them at the back of the broom as they are coming out of it, just like a stardust or kind of magic. So here I'm just playing around, trying to decide where everything is going to go, and once I'm happy with the placement, I can then go ahead and stick everything down with my white glue. I also used my Nouveau Drops to add some eyes on my card. Now I'm adding white dots, and then later on when these are dry, I'm going to add a tiny little dot on the inside with black. You will see that at the finished photos. And of course I placed the little nose in place as well. Now the card is pretty much finished. I'm going to play a little bit with my background now, and I'm going to add stars. Now I'm using a brush which is slightly wet, and I'm just touching the background, and then I'm going to use a clean paper towel and just dab off all that water. This is going to react with the background, which is Distress Oxide ink, and it's going to lighten up those areas. Now I don't want my stars to be very bright, since I want the brightest of the stars on my sky to be the ones that are coming out of the broom, and this is why I decided to do this process at the end, just to make sure that I don't make my stars super bright. Hope that makes sense. And finally I'm using my white Posca pen to add some random white dots. They are super tiny. This is a fine marker, and now my background doesn't look as flat, but at the same time it's not going to be super busy. I have created a card base out of black cardstock that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to stick my panel on top by using foam tape at the back, which is going to add some dimension. So as you can see, my panel is slightly smaller than my standard card, just about an eighth of an inch from each side, so I get a lovely black border. As a sentiment, I used a Tim Holtz sticker that says trick or treat, and my card is finished. I had so much fun creating it, and I hope you had fun and got inspired too. Here are some close-up photos on today's card. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.